Hello friends, the BJP government in Karnataka has come up with another attack on the secular fabric of our nation. The new anti-conversion bill has been alleged by many to violate the secular fabric of our nation. Recently, the Karnataka Legislative Assembly passed a bill to regulate and penalize religious conversions in the state through voice vote. The Karnataka Protection of Right to Freedom of Religion Bill 2021. See the irony. Here the name says Protection of Right to Freedom of Religion, whereas in reality it is an attack on this very same right. The bill, also known simply as the Anti-Conversion Bill, has categorized as allurements the promise of marriage, free education, free medical treatment and jobs, and hence terms them unlawful reasons for religious conversion. Today, in this video, we at the Upfront try to keep in front of you more information and details on the new anti-conversion bill. I am Nihal Mohammed and you're watching the Upfront. The bill is similar to the bills brought by the BJP in Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh and Himachal Pradesh. But the points mentioned in this bill are more stringent compared to any other such law in any state of India. The Karnataka Protection of Right to Freedom of Religion Bill 2021 provides for the protection of the right to freedom of religion and prohibition of unlawful conversion from one religion to another by misrepresentation, force, undue influence, coercion, allurement or by any fraudulent means. According to the bill, the term religious converter will be applicable to anyone in the post of father, priest, purohit, pandit, maulvi or mullah. Under the bill, a person planning to convert or a converter has to give a 30-day prior notice to the district magistrate about the conversion. A declaration is to be given even after conversion. Under the proposed law, marriages conducted with the intention of conversions can be declared null and void by a family or jurisdictional court. Under the proposed Karnataka law, whoever is found guilty of conversion will face jail term of 3 to 5 years and will also be liable to pay a fine of ₹25,000. If the person who has been illegally converted is a minor, a woman or a person from a scheduled caste or scheduled tribe community, they face a jail term of 3 to 10 years and a fine of ₹50,000. The Uttar Pradesh law has prescribed less stringent punishment. While the minimum punishment in UP is 1 year, in Karnataka it is 3 years. While the minimum fine in UP is ₹15,000, in Karnataka it is ₹25,000. In case of a mass conversion, which is defined under the law as conversion of two or more people, the accused person can face 3 to 10 years imprisonment and a fine of ₹1 lakh. Moreover, an appropriate court can also order compensation of up to ₹5 lakh, which will have to be paid by the accused to the victim of conversion. A repeat offender can face a jail term of not less than 5 years and shall also be liable to a fine of ₹2 lakh. The bill says that any marriage done for the sole purpose of conversion shall be declared illegal and void. The reason the Karnataka government has given for this new bill is that this mass conversions are happening across the state and there is no legislation prevailing in the state to check it. Hence, we are bringing this new law. But the question here is whether the government has done any investigations into these mass conversions. In the past, we have seen that same things were said about love jihad, and later many top level investigations and bodies clarified that there is nothing called love jihad. The government has no data regarding how many conversions have taken place in the state. Karnataka Congress chief DK Shivkumar literally tore the copy of the proposed bill in the House, deeming it unconstitutional and accusing the government of sneaking the bill into the House without discussing it in the Business Advisory Committee or listing it as business of the House. Many political parties and socio-religious organizations have spoken against the proposed bill and showed their dissent. Protests have also taken place opposing the bill. Anti-conversion bill will be a black mark on the state, will affect foreign investment, says D.K. Shivakumar. Much like other anti-conversion laws introduced in recent years, the proposed law for Karnataka also requires those wishing to convert to provide 60 days prior notice to a district magistrate. Much like these other laws, this is also quite clearly a violation of the right to privacy, something the Himachal Pradesh High Court held back in 2012, a position that has only become clearer after the Supreme Court's right to privacy judgment in 2017. The marriage provisions are also one of the many reasons for which this bill is under fire. No attempts have been made to address the questions asked by the Gujarat High Court when it stayed the marriage-related provisions in Gujarat. The vague definition of allurement is an attack on a person's liberty. The bill says that educational institutions, old age homes, hospitals, etc. come under the definition of allurement. The inclusion of promise to marry within the concept of allurement is also an extremely problematic aspect of the Karnataka bill. By adding this here, the law creates another avenue to harass interfaith couples, which is already what the main conversion by marriage provision does. Remember that even an attempt to convert is punishable under this law. So every time there is some extremely vague concept of conversion, it expands the scope for misuse. Why the state should be entering into the domain of what is a private choice for couples has always been unclear, and this new element only makes it worse. Apart from these, questions such as why maximum punishment is given in cases where SCs and STs and women are the ones converting are also heard from those opposing the law. These are some of the many reasons to oppose this law. This is not the first time that the BJP government has brought a law which creates more problems instead of benefiting people. The introduction and passage of such bills in the assembly will only waste precious time of the assembly, which in reality was meant to solve and discuss the problems of the common man. It is very clear that such attempts are done to further polarize the society which we live in on religious lines and garner votes in the name of religion. Let us oppose such discriminatory bills and try to secure the secular fabric of our nation. The government needs to stop this dirty game and concentrate on the real issues faced by common man, like inflation. If you like the content we provide, please subscribe to the Upfront and press the bell icon to get notification of all our recent updates. Please share our videos and educate others. Thank you.